Hello and welcome! My previous video outlined the primary criteria to remember while choosing between the three most popular JSON API data sources. It was a conceptual video where I walked you through the diagram. In this video, I will dive right into hands-on configuration and go over the steps I made to create these two charts. They look identical. The first is done via the JSON API data source, and the second is via Infinity. The visualization itself is done with the help of the fantastic Apache eCharts panel. Are you ready? Let's go! For this first demo, I will use the freshly released Grafana version 9.3.1. The installation steps are identical for all three plugins. Click the hamburger menu on the left-hand side, then Administration, Plugins menu, start typing eCharts, click on the plugins card, and then the Install button. Go back to the plugins menu, start typing Infinity, click on the plugins card, and then Install button. Repeat again. Plugins menu, start typing JSON API, click on the plugins card, and then Install button. Now, if I create a panel and open the drop-down with all installed visualizations, I see the Apache eCharts here. However, I do not yet have Infinity or JSON API in the data sources drop-down. Before I can see them there, I need to add them as data sources. In Administration Data Sources menu, click Add Data Source, start typing Infinity, click on the Plugins card. Repeat the same for JSON. Go to the Data Sources menu, the Add Data Source button, start typing JSON, and click the Plugins card. And now, if I create a panel, I can see the data sources in the drop-down to choose from. Okay, Grafana is all set. The other important component is the data to display. I choose the Bureau of Labor and Statistics, BLS.gov, since they provide the metric I'm interested in today, the unemployment rate. There are many more open datasets out there. You can try data.gov or data.nasa.gov or kaggle.com. The list goes on and on. On the BLS.gov, I found this Data Tools menu and then the Public Data API section. On this page, you can find two options to request data. Version 1.0 has more restrictions but doesn't require registration. For simple experiments, this option is more than enough. I decided to register to try how version 2.0 works. They ask to provide a company name and my email, and in a matter of minutes, I received the email with my unique API key. When your request contains the API key, the API server knows you're registered to use version 2.0 and lifts all limits that would have been imposed otherwise. Let me return to this page and go to BLS API signature link. Here, they give you instructions on how to request the data. The basics are you need to use this URL for all requests with only one mandatory parameter, a series ID. Let me copy this link and add this data series at the end. That would be the complete address for the data file. To check that, I paste the link into my browser. Voila! Here is the data in JSON format that BLS.gov returns for processing on my side. Let's switch back to Grafana. Open Administration Data Sources. If I open the Infinity configuration and click Save and Test, I see this OK message. That means that for elementary work, there is no need to change anything in the default settings you got right after the installation. If I open JSON API and click Save and Test, I see this error. One parameter is mandatory for JSON API. It is URL. I enter the URL I copied from BLS.gov instruction page with series ID at the end. Then Save and Test action shows success. That means the data flow, but I want a little more. I want to use multiple series and parameters. That's why I remove the series ID and only keep the primary link I copied from BLS.gov, save and test. This error is okay. The request attempt failed, but for the apparent reason that series ID is not specified, I will specify the series ID later on the panel configuration page. Now I create a new dashboard and save it. Add a new panel, select data source, JSON API to begin with, and switch to the table view to instantly see if the data flows from the source, from BLS.gov. This is some Grafana default data, not yet what I want. Here is the place to configure your JSON API. Remember the series ID I omitted on the data source configuration page? Now it's the time to specify it on the panel configuration page. To find the series ID, I go to the BLS.gov Data Tools menu, Data Finder section, and start typing unemployment in the search box. The first link is the national unemployment rate. Click on it, scroll down if needed, and here is the series ID. Highlight and copy. Switch back to Grafana and paste it into the path parameter with slash symbol in front. Data is not yet flowing. This is because JSON API expects you to describe what elements exactly you want from the data source file. It is down on the Fields tab. One way to look up the elements' names is to look at the actual file. I take the primary link, add series ID, and open the file in my browser. Copy the content to open it in the VS Code. I use VS Code because I like formatting function in there. Now the data files looks readable and I can see the structure. Surely you can look for metadata on the website as well. I can see only one series in data file, which is expected since I requested one, but there could be multiple series. The name of elements I want to work with are year, month, and value. Switch back to Grafana, Field tab, and start typing the reference instructions. I say to start from the root element results, then the series element with index 0. Even though I only have one series, they could be multiple. And then for the series, I want all data elements and the year for my first field. The second field looks the same, except I point to period name, and in the last field, I point to value. With that configuration, here is what the successful request looks like. I select the Apache eCharts in the dropdown to convert it into nice looking visualization. Now I need to configure the visualization panel. It is done in a free text format on the right hand side in this Monica code editor. Logically, the configuration could consist of two parts: reading the data from Grafana data frame using JavaScript and setting up the panel parameters in JSON format. I read the data points into arrays using this JavaScript code. RefID is the query's name from the left-hand side, where I populated year, period name, and value. The year and period name need to be combined into two-dimensional array, since it's the same time metric, month and year. For the visual configuration, there is a simple way of doing it. Volkov Labs has created this helpful resource, echarts.volkovlabs.io. You can find almost all examples published on the official Apache eCharts demo website in there. We adjusted the code for every single one and made it ready to use in Grafana as is. For my chart example, I open the main menu and select line from the list. I wanted the smooth line chart as my base, so I went to the edit mode and copied the code from here. Then I paste it into my Grafana panel. Switch the table view toggle. Here is the chart in action right away. The code is working as is. I surely want my data points though. Hence, I used value A for the data element in the series option. Need to reverse for the right order. And month year A for the data element of the x-axis option. Need to reverse as well. I could have called it a day, but I wanted to spice things up a little bit and emphasize minimum and maximum values. My steps were: go to the echarts.wolkoflabs.io again, click examples, select line from the list, scroll down to the graph temperature change in the coming week. It displays what looks very close to my idea. Go to the edit mode and discover that the emphasis is done via mark point parameter. Copy the inspiration and paste it into my Grafana. Now I have maximum and minimum unemployment rate emphasized. As a final touch, I like to customize colors, fonts, and sizes. This gives a little hint of sophistication and taste. One more modification is adding zoom. With that, I can zoom in and zoom out. Beautiful! This is what my dashboard looks like for now. The national unemployment rate from January 2020 until now. Now let's build the exact same visualization with Infinity Data Source. Before I do, I copy the visualization panel code from the Monica Code editor. I will reuse it without any modifications. Add a panel, select the eCharts panel for visualization, and paste the code. The error is expected since I still need to set up the data source. Switch to the table view. It is the data from Grafana's default data source. Select the Infinity data source from the drop-down. Keep the type JSON. There are many more types to choose from, but this video is about JSON. Leave parser as default. Source URL. Here's where I enter the primary URL I was given on bls.gov, plus the series ID at the end. Exactly the same as I already used for the JSON API data source. Open the parsing option parameter and specify the root element results, and then all elements from the first existing series, which is the only series in my case so far. That's it, data flow. Note that I do not need to know the data structure to read from the file. The data source reads everything and shows me the headers right here. They are the same as I already have in the eCharts panel code. Now, if I switch to the table view, I see the exact same visualization. Save, apply, and now admire two identical visualizations created using different data sources. Let's move further and add parameters to my API request. As bls.gov mentioned on their instruction page right here, they provide 3 years of data by default. Let's say I want to expand the default and start from 2013. Let me open the edit mode for the JSON API data source. First things first, on the path tab, I change the HTTP request from GET to POST. I will send my parameters in the request's body since the body has more flexible format. What exactly to send you can find on the bls.gov instruction page. I copy it from here and paste it into the body tab. Too many spaces for my taste. Specify the series ID. I can take it from the path tab. Remove the second series ID. Change the start year and end year. Here is the place to use my API key. When I send the request with the API key, the BLS API server recognizes me and lets me through some restrictions that otherwise would have been off limits. Switch to table view to confirm that I have more years of data on my chart. Not yet. I need to delete the path parameter. Refresh, and now I do. Switch the table view to confirm the line on the chart looks different. Yes, it does. So we just added a custom time range and an API key to the API request and translated the results using JSON API data source. Now let's apply the same changes to the panel with the Infinity data source. I start with copying the body request from here. Then open the panel in edit mode. The question now becomes where to insert the requested body. It took me some time to find that place. You need to click these options right here. Change the HTTP method to POST. Keep the body type as raw change the body content type to JSON, and paste the body into the body content. Refresh. Now I should have more years in my chart, and I don't. Oh, I as well need to remove the series ID from the URL. And now I do. Save, apply, and admire. Now I have an unemployment rate from 2013 until now, taken directly from the BLS website. All is great so far. Now let's display multiple series. Let's say I want to compare the national unemployment rate with Florida's state unemployment rate. To find Florida unemployment series ID, go to bls.gov. Data Tools menu, Data Finder section, start typing unemployment and click on this link. Scroll down if needed. Here it is, the series ID for Florida state unemployment rate. According to the instruction, you can request multiple series in the same request. However, data sources expect the same file length. That means the number of data points across all series should match. In other words, if one series returns two data points, for instance, November and December, whereas the other returns only one, December, then the data source would not automatically translate it into the Grafana data frame. It could do it, but with some extra steps. I do not want to go that far, so instead I will do the following. Replicate request A using this little button here. Request B appears. I replace the national series ID with the Florida one. Change to the table view. Below here I have a drop-down. Change to B to verify the data flow. All is good. In the eChart code, I will add one more set of arrays. By the way, I would need them all anyway, regardless of whether I have one request for two series or a separate request for each series. So I need the same steps to read from the B request. I populate year, period name, and value. Next, I need similar mapping to map year and month values. Then I add another series, copy the existing one, and paste it after the first one. Rename to Florida. Assign element data to value B. Okay, looking good except for color. I change it to my favorite red, and oh, now the two data series overlap. It's because the requested data has been cached. So here I have 5 minutes of caching time. I change to 0 seconds in query B and to 0 seconds in query A. Click the refresh button. All right, finally I got what I wanted, the national and Florida state unemployment rates starting from January 2013. To replicate two series on the Infinity panel, I copy the code from the JSON API panel. Then open the panel with Infinity Data Source in edit mode and paste the code. Duplicate the request A. In there, go to the options and replace the nation series ID with Florida state series ID. That's all for this. Save, apply, and now admire two identical charts with two data series displaying the data from bls.gov. This is all I planned for this video. Now you know how to create these visualizations on a very detailed level. As always, remember to check the description box to find the resources I mentioned in this video. Share your thoughts on what video I should create next. Thanks for watching and see you next time.